having a line of sight between them. Means there is no obstacle between the transmitter and the receiving base stations. Okay, so we will measure the signal strength for these unobstructed line of sight path between the transmitter and the receiver sites. For example, this is the model, free space propagation model. It is used in microwave and satellite communication systems. So in this, we will have a free space equation known as FRISS, free space equation. So this is the equation that is measured at the receiver site. So the power received at the receiving antenna is given by PR, and it is equal to PT GT GR lambda square divided by 4 pi square D square L. This is the free space equation that is used for the calculation of received power at the receiving station. To measure the quality of the received signal, this free space FRISS equation is used. So it is given by PR is equal to PT GT GR lambda square divided by 4 pi square D square L, where PR is the received power, PT is transmitted power, GT GR is the transmitting and receiving antenna gains, D is the transmitter and receiver separation distance in meters, L is the path loss component, and lambda is wavelength in meters. This is very important equation, the FRISS free space equation for free space propagation model. Now in this equation, the gain of antenna G is related with its effective apertures AE. Effective aperture is given by the gain, so it can be described as AE is can be written as 4 pi AE upon lambda square. Its gain of an defined in terms of effective aperture AE, and it is given by G is equal to 4 pi AE upon lambda square. AE is related with the physical size of the antenna, means the effective aperture will be related with the size of antenna, and lambda is your wavelength that is related with the carrier frequency, and you can describe lambda is equal to C upon F, where C is a speed of light in meters per second, and F is frequency, carrier frequency in hertz. Further, we can also describe C by F is equal to 2 pi C upon omega C, where C is again your speed of light and omega C is the carrier frequency in radians per second. Now, if we will consider the isotropic antennas or isotropic radiators that will radiate the signals in all the directions with equal signal strength or equal unity gain. Means when we are considering a transmitting antenna that will radiate their signal equally into all directions with equal signal strength or equal gain or unity gain, then that thing is known as isotropic antennas. Now EIRP is the effective isotropic radiated power. This is the amount of power in an isotropic antenna that an isotropic antenna emit to produce the peak power density in the direction of maximum antenna gain. So we can describe the EIRP as it is the product of transmitting power with the transmitting gain, PT into GT. So EIRP is your effective isotropic radiated power, which is the product of transmitting power and the gain, GT. Mostly the antenna gain are described with the unit decibels. ठीक है, एंड वी विल राइट डीबीआई व्हेन वी आर कंसीडरिंग द आइसोट्रॉपिक एंटीना. सो इट विल डिस्क्राइब द गेन इन डेसिबल्स फॉर आइसोट्रॉपिक एंटीना डीबीआई. नाउ हाउ यू विल कैलकुलेट दिस डेसिबल? व्हाट इज डेसिबल? डेसिबल इज बेसिकली अ लॉगरिथमिक यूनिट दैट इज यूज टू डिस्क्राइब अ रेशियो बिटवीन द टू वैल्यूज ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज. Suppose the two values in our radio signals are the transmitting power and the receiving power. So we can consider the transmitting power as P1 and the receiving power as P2. So we can calculate their decibel value with the help of this equation. The ratio of two values P1 and P2 in decibel is given by 10 log of P1 by P2. Where P1 is transmitting power and P2 is receiving power. So if both the powers, transmitting power and receiving power, are known, then we can calculate their decibels by having this formula, 10 log P1 upon P2. For example, if the transmitting power P1 is 100 watt and receiving power is 1 watt, then decibel ratio can be written as 10 log of 100 by 1. So you will solve the log for it, this equation, and you will get the answer as 20 dB. Yes, clear है यहाँ तक? समझ आ रहा है सबको? Yes, students, यहाँ तक समझ आ रहा है? Clear है? यस रोहिणी, रितिका, तनु, समझ आ रहा है?
यस मैम, समझ आ रहा
है. यस मैम, आ रहा है समझ.
ओके, नेक्स्ट इज अबाउट डेसिबल मीटर्स, डीबीएम. इट इंडिकेट्स द पावर रेशियो इन डेसिबल्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू 1 मीटर वॉट एज अ रेफरेंस पावर. So when you will consider this meter as a reference power, then the unit will become dBm, decibel meters. So for example, transmitting power, let us suppose the transmitting power is 100 watt in dBm's, then it can be described as 10 log 100 W by 1 meter per watt. So we can calculate in terms of meters. As 1 meter watt is equal to 0 dBm, 1 watt is 30 dBm, 10 watt is 40 dBm. So in this way you can calculate this unit. Similarly, the dBm watt, the dB watt, decibels in watt, it indicates the power ratio in decibel with 1 watt as a reference power level. Formula for this is, let the transmitting power is 100 watt, then it can be expressed in dBw as 10 log of 100 watt per 1 watt. So it is equal to 20 decibel watt. Next is the equation for free space path loss. Path loss is defined as the difference between the effective transmitted power and the received power. So the free space path loss can be defined as the path loss for free space model. So it is basically the difference between the effective transmitted power and the received power. कितनी power transmit हुई है और कितनी power receive हुई है, उन दोनों में जो भी difference आएगा, that is your path loss. And it is expressed in decibels, as path loss in decibel is given by 10 log of ratio of transmitted power to the received power. PT upon PR. So as per your Friis equation, you can describe the path loss component as minus 10 log of GT GR lambda square divided by 4 pi square T square. So the Friis equation holds when distance D is the far field of the transmitting antenna, means when the एंटीना इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी द ट्रांसमिटिंग एंटीना एंड द रिसीविंग एंटीना, बोथ आर वेरी फार अवे फ्रॉम ईच अदर. फॉर दैट द फ्रिस इक्वेशन विल बी यूज. So for far field, this equation of transmitting antenna is defined as the region beyond the far field distance. So that distance d is defined as df, that is far field distance, and it is given by 2 d square upon lambda. So here d is the largest physical dimensions of the antenna and lambda is the wavelength. Skip this. Now here the radio propagation mechanisms in which your mobile receiver and the base stations both are situated at a very far away distance from each other. Okay, so you will see in this diagram that we are having a base station and a mobile receiver, and we are having in between the various obstacles. So obstacles between the transmitting and receiving sites are like the the large buildings, the residential areas, the various factories, mountains. So these kind of obstacles are in between the transmitting and receiving stations. So how the signal will be traveled from the transmitting site to receiving site, and how they can have the different obstacles in between their path. So due to these obstacles, the signal get diffracted, the signal get reflected back. So we are having the phenomena like diffractions and reflections. So when there is no obstacle between the base station and the mobile receiver, then the signal can travel directly from the base station to the mobile receiver, and that path is known as line of sight path or direct path, in which there is no obstacle. When there is obstacle between the base station and the receiver, then the signal get deflected from those obstacles and the signal get reflected or scattered. So we will discuss how these signals get different scattering, diffractions and reflections when they travel over to a long distance. So here this phenomena is discussed, how the signal get diffracted, absorbed, reflected, refracted and scattered. So in first diagram you will see when there is no obstacle between the transmission and reception side, then the signal will travel directly. So there is a line of sight path that can be existed between the transmitting station and the receiving device. That path is known as line of sight or direct path. Second is when the signal will have large number of obstacles between the transmitting and receiving sides, then the signal reflection will be take place. So here the signal will reflected back towards the transmitting side. Another phenomena is refraction. In refraction, some part of signal is reflected and some part of signal. The signal will be having scattered in equally in all directions. And in absorption, the signal will be absorbed by the obstacle. It is not passed to the receiving device. So these are the various phenomena that occur during the propagation of waves: reflection, refraction, diffraction, absorption and scattering. When the signal travels over to the long distance from transmitting side to the receiving side, and the signal will experience these kind of phenomena while propagation. Now, first phenomena, that is reflection. Reflection occurs when the wave impinges upon the obstruction that is much larger in size compared to the wavelength of the signal. So when your wave will strike out with the obstacle, in which the wavelength, in which the obstacle have large size and the wavelength as compared to the wavelength of the traveling signals. So that obstacles can be, can cause reflection of signal. So these are occurred from the large buildings and the earth curvatures. The reflected waveform may interfere with the original signal and it can produce constructive and destructive effects. So when the radio wave signal in one medium travels upon another medium and it will have different electrical properties, then the wave can partially reflect it or it can partially transmit it. So when your wave travel through a perfect conductor and through a perfect dielectric, it will experience different kind of reactions. So when your radio wave propagate from a perfect dielectric medium, then part of the energy is transmitted into the second medium and part of the energy is reflected back into the first medium. And there is no loss of energy during absorption. And when the radio wave travels to a perfect conductor, then all the incident energy is reflected back into the first medium. So complete reflection will be there during the wave when it travels through a conductor. So there is no loss of energy. So the fraction that is reflected is described by the Fresnel equation and it is dependent upon the incoming light polarization and the angle of incidence. So during the reflection, when the electromagnetic wave are transmitted in into the two different mediums, then it will experience the polarization effect. It will experience the two kind of polarizations, horizontal and vertical polarization and left hand and right hand circular polarization. So in a vertical polarization, it is commonly used in terrestrial mobile radio communication. In very high frequency band, vertical polarization produces the higher field strength near to ground. So the mobile antennas for vertical polarizations are convenient to implement in very high radio frequency band. In left hand and right hand circular polarization, it is mostly used in satellite communication. It can be used together for well-designed communication links so that the transmission capacity can be doubled for a given frequency band. So in now the ground reflection, the two-ray model in the mobile radio channel, a signal direct path between the base station and the mobile station is rarely used because during the propagation, it can have the obstacles in between them. So the free space propagation model is inaccurate in most of the cases when they are used. Okay, so the model that we have just discussed, the free space model, it is basically used for the base stations and mobile users when there is little obstructions between them. Fine. So the next model is two-ray model known as ground reflection model. It is based on geometric optics and it is considered as for both direct path and for the ground reflected propagation path. It is reasonably accurate for predicting the large scale signal strength over to the distance of several kilometers for mobile radio systems that uses tall towers. Fine. So जो अभी हमने previous model discuss किया है, free space model, that free space model is used for direct path. ठीक है, और मोस्टली हम सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन में फ्री स्पेस मॉडल डिस्कस करते हैं, ठीक है। इन द मोबाइल रेडियो चैनल वी विल यूज दिस टू रे मॉडल नोन एज ग्राउंड रिफ्लेक्टेड मॉडल इन विच वी आर हैविंग द ज्योमेट्रिक्स दैट इज दैट विल कंसिडर द डायरेक्ट पाथ एंड द रिफ्लेक्टेड पाथ फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड। सो फॉर लार्ज स्केल फॉर प्रडिक्टिंग द लार्ज स्केल सिग्नल स्ट्रेंथ ओवर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस, ठीक है, इन विच सेवरल किलोमीटर्स डिस्टेंस विल बी कंसिडर्ड फॉर मोबाइल रेडियो कम्युनिकेशन, दिस ग्राउंड रिफ्लेक्शन मॉडल इज यूज। दिस इज द मॉडल फॉर ग्राउंड रिफ्लेक्शन इन विच वी विल कंसिडर द टोटल रिसीव्ड सिग्नल स्ट्रेंथ विल बी द सम ऑफ टू पैरामीटर्स, सम ऑफ टू कॉम्पोनेंट्स, दैट इज component of received signal ER and the component of line of sight signal that is direct path, ठीक है। ER is your reflected path and LOS is your line of sight means direct path. So the total energy of the received signal will be the sum of these two, the reflected signal and the direct signal, ठीक है। अब जैसे आप यहाँ पर डायग्राम में भी देख रहे हो, आपके पास T T is here transmitting side or transmitting antenna and R is receiving antenna, ठीक है। HT is the height of transmitting antenna and HR is the height of receiving antenna, ठीक है। Now the transmitting and receiving antenna they both can have two types of signal, one is direct signal and other is reflected signal, ठीक है। Direct signal is when there is no obstacle between the transmitting and receiving path, ठीक है। So it is considered as LOS, line of sight. So here the energy is electric, the energy is LOS, and when we will consider the ground reflections means your signal from the transmitting side will strike out with the ground signal with the ground and it is reflected back towards the receiving side. So for this we will consider the two angles here, one is the angle of incidence phi I and one is the angle of reflection that is phi R, fine. So we will consider the ground reflected signal as ER. So in this model the total reflected signal at the receiving side will be considered as E total. E total is the total signal at the receiving side, the total received signal. So it is the sum of direct signal plus reflected signal. ELOS is direct signal and ER is the reflected signal from the ground. So in this model, we will consider the path difference between the line of sight and the ground reflected path. Both will be calculated and will it will be included into the equation. The path difference between the line of sight direct path and the ground reflected path can be given as the distance between the height of transmitting antenna and the height of receiving antenna. So it can be given as twice of HT upon HT into HR divided by D. HT is height of transmitting antenna, HR is height of receiving antenna, and D is the distance between the transmitting and receiving antenna. So their path difference delta will be considered as 2HT HR upon D. Next point is the phase difference between the two electric field components and the time delay between the arrival of the two components. So this path phase difference can be given as 4 pi HT HR upon D into lambda. D is distance, L is wavelength, lambda. D is distance, lambda is wavelength, HT is height of transmitting antenna, HR is height of receiving antenna. So the phasor difference can be calculated with the help of this equation. Now, for large distance, D will be greater than square root of ht into hr. So from this equations we can calculate the received power at the receiving side of the antenna. It is given as pt gt gr ht square hr square upon d raised to power 4. जैसे हमने फ्री स्पेस मॉडल में रिसीव्ड पावर की इक्वेशन एनालाइज की थी, वैसे ही हमने ग्राउंड रिफ्लेक्शन मॉडल में भी रिसीव्ड पावर की इक्वेशन एनालाइज करनी है. दैट इज गिवन एज जी टी पी टी जी टी जी आर फोर्टी स्क्वायर एच टी स्क्वायर एच आर स्क्वायर अपॉन डी रेस टू पावर 4. पी टी इज ट्रांसमिटिंग पावर, पी आर इज रिसीविंग पावर, जी टी इज गेन ऑफ ट्रांसमिटिंग एंटीना, जी आर इज गेन ऑफ रिसीविंग एंटीना, एच टी हाइट ऑफ ट्रांसमिटिंग एंटीना, एच आर इज हाइट ऑफ रिसीविंग एंटीना एंड डी इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन ट्रांसमिटिंग एंड रिसीविंग एंटीना. सो हेयर इज द ग्राउंड रिफ्लेक्टेड मॉडल रिसीव्ड पावर इक्वेशन. सो टूडे वी हैव डिस्कस टू मॉडल्स, फ्री स्पेस मॉडल. दोनों इक्वेशंस क्लियर हैं, फ्री स्पेस मॉडल और ग्राउंड रिफ्लेक्टेड मॉडल की? यस स्टूडेंट्स, बॉयज समझ आ गए सबको?
यस मैम.
यस मैम.
ओके. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे.